Hey developers, today we're exploring JetBrains coding agent Juni, which was just made publicly available this week. I'm excited to show you how this tool integrates directly with JetBrains IDEs and can help us become more productive developers. Let's see how Juni fits into our everyday coding workflow and the practical benefits it might offer. JetBrains Junie is more than just another AI coding assistant. It's a full-fledged coding agent designed to work alongside you in your IDE. Unlike traditional AI assistants that just suggest code snippets, Juni can handle complex multi-step tasks autonomously, from understanding your codebase to implementing new features and running tests. What makes Juni special is the ability to explore your project, generate context-appropriate code, run tests when needed, and present results for your review, all while you maintain complete control over the process. In other words, it aims to be a true coding partner rather than just a smart autocomplete tool. Currently, Juni is available for IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate, PyCharm Pro, WebStorm, and Golang, with more IDEs coming soon. JetBrains has also recently introduced a free tier, making it accessible to more developers who want to experience AI-powered coding. In today's video, we'll explore how Juni understands and navigates our existing codebases, challenge it to write a completely new application from scratch, and see how effectively we can guide the agent to write code that matches our specific preferences and coding standards. I think it's important to remember with all of these AI coding tools that you are the pilot, not the passenger. Let's dive in. All right, so before we take a look at some code, I want to give you a couple resources that will give you some more information about Juni. First off, jetbrains.com/Juni. This is the landing page, tells you how to kind of get started with it. It's a plugin for IntelliJ. So I'm using IntelliJ Ultimate Edition. This is a plugin that you can kind of just add to the existing IDE. So you can go down again. Here's where it is available currently, coming soon to these, what it can do for you. So you can go through and learn a little bit more about it. There's also an FAQ. This is a really good starting place to kind of learn more about it. One of the questions that I had right away was, it doesn't seem to have the ability to change which model you're using. So I was curious what model it uses. So if you look at which large language models do AI features use, currently we use third-party models from OpenAI, Google, and Anthropic. So I'm not really sure which one it's using underneath the hood, just so you know. And I talked to somebody over at JetBrains, and I think this will be a future enhancement where you can go ahead and pick your model. But for right now, you don't have any control over that. So if you have some other questions about getting started with some of their AI tools, this FAQ is a really good place to start. Also, there's a really good blog post on the JetBrains guide, or a guide, I'm sorry, not a blog post, by my good friend Siva, who goes through kind of everything to installing it. Again, this is a plugin from the marketplace, so you'll have to go into JetBrains or IntelliJ IDEA and go ahead and add this as a plugin. And then he walks through a bunch of things that you can do to go through this. So really great guide there. But from that, we're going to take two steps to this. I want to show you Juni in an existing code base, and then I want to go ahead and write a new application, letting it just do its thing. And then I want to provide a way to kind of guide the AI to our preferences and our coding standards. So first one, I have just this simple Spring to-dos app that I have. Again, this, what I'm about to do may work on a larger scale project, but I just wanted to keep it pretty simple for today. So I have this existing code base, and I'm going to go ahead and open Juni. So once it's installed, you'll see a little gutter icon for it. And then you can come in here and you can ask it a couple things. You can do code, which is like, hey, here's the task I want to give you. Go ahead and complete it. Or you can give it just ask, where you're kind of chatting back and forth with the AI. There's also a Brave mode, as we see, allow Juni to execute terminal commands without confirmation. So if you don't want to be constantly saying yes, allow, you can go ahead and select Brave Mode. And I believe this is sandboxed to the project that you're working in. So just some information about that. Okay, so I'm going to start in Ask Mode. In this first one, I just want to get some information about the project that I've just kind of onboarded to. So I might go with something like this. Please explore this code base and provide a clear overview of what this project is about. Specifically, here are a bunch of things that I want to know about this project. Please focus on help me understand this project and how it works at a conceptual level rather than all the implementation details. This is what I like to do when I first kind of get introduced to a code base. So I'm going to go ahead and run that. And again, I'm in the chat mode, the ask mode. I'm not in the coding mode. So what it's going to do is it's just going to go in and follow my instructions here. So it's getting the structure. You can see the to-do data model has been reviewed. Reviewing a simple structure with fields for user ID, ID, title, and completion status. It's going through and looking at all these different files in here. So the to-do repository. In a larger code base, I've noticed that it may run commands like ls or grep or pull like different files in there. So it has different approaches to working with existing code bases. So again, this is something that I like to do. You see terminal ls la open, it's going through. So this is going to take a minute or so, and it's just going to go through, you know, larger code bases may take a little bit longer, but I like this as a first step, just kind of getting me introduced to the project. All right, and it says respond to your question. Here is what it is. You can view this in an editor tab. So now I can come in and close this, and here's what it came up with. So the core purpose and functionality, what problem it's trying to solve. Here are some of the main components and modules. Here are the technologies involved. So if I didn't want to dig through a project and figure out all the technologies involved, I could see that it's using Spring Boot 3.4.4, it's using JDK 24, and these different dependencies. It has a project structure. Here's how it's laid out. Here's the primary data flow. It starts up, the command line runner executes automatically. So that's good. It's giving us something that we can dive into the code and look at right away. And then just gives us a little bit of a data flow there. Here's some architectural decisions that were made. Here's the domain and the industry, et cetera. So this is my first step, kind of exploring a code base. Juni does a good job of this. You can give it any kind of instruction that you want for what you're trying to achieve as far as your understanding of a code base. All right, so the next thing that I'm gonna ask it to do is write a complete application. So I want an application that basically reaches out to this fake API called JSON placeholder service and access this list of posts and basically creates like a full CRUD REST API around this. So I'm gonna copy this. We're gonna go over to start.spring.io. I'm going to fill out a new project, dev.danvega. Let's just call this posts, and we'll go ahead and use the web dependency. And that's all we really need to get started. So I'll go ahead and generate a new project, download that zip, and open it up in IntelliJ IDEA. All right, so I've opened my application. I'm going to open up Juni. Now we're going to use the code feature. I would like you to create a full CRUD REST API that retrieves posts from the JSON placeholder service. So I'm not giving it a ton of information. Again, I think I talk about this a lot when it comes to prompt engineering, being able to give as much context as you can to an LLM. This is a demo, pretty quick one, so I think this should work out. So let's go ahead and hit go, and now it's going to think through this. So what I love about Juni is that you can see everything that it's doing, and it really is kind of an autonomous agent. We've just given it a task, and it comes up with a plan. So based on that prompt, here's the plan. I have to explore the project structure to understand what we're working with. We're going to create a post model class to represent the data from that JSON placeholder service. We're going to create a post service to handle communication with that external API. Good. Create a post controller that exposes CRUD REST endpoints. Awesome. Configure any necessary properties in application.properties, and then test the implementation to ensure it works correctly. Without giving it a whole lot of information, that's a really good plan to get started with. And I just noticed this, but I'm going to take me off screen here since we are covering up all of the wonderful things Juni is doing. But you can go through and you can see that it starts creating things for us. So we have some config in here. We have a model. We have a service. And I've noticed that I'm probably not going to, okay, it is creating a REST template in there. Sometimes I see Juni kind of create files, and then it will go back through that plan and go, actually, we don't really need that. Let me get rid of that. So it is able to kind of go through and figure this out. Yes, I'm going to approve that. So it's making some changes to our application.properties. I really like this. In other previous iterations of this, it was not using a configuration property for something like this. It was hard coding in a service file. So I'm a big fan of that. But you could see everything that it's doing. Now, what we'll end up with is something that works. This is going to work. And I mean, most of the time it has for me, maybe not all of the time, but it works. And I like what we get out of this agent, but there is another way to do this. And we'll kind of talk through this. We'll talk about the code that it creates. And then I'll show you something that I'm doing with any of these AI coding agents, whether it's Windsurf, Cursor, or JetBrains Juni, which is being able, having the ability to kind of guide the agent to your preferences, your coding standards, how you like to write code, how you like to, you know, what libraries you like to use, what features you like to use. We have a way that we can kind of ask the LLM here to write all of this code based on some things that we like to do. Then we see it's asking us if we want to run the test. I'm just going to skip that for now, but you can go ahead and run it. And if that test were to fail, Juni would see that and then say, okay, based on the failures that happened, do we need to adjust the test? Do we need to adjust some code? What's going on there? So it has the ability to run something and then figure out based on the execution, does it need to change anything? It's even creating a README file. So it's created a README file, giving us some information about this, which I really like. That is not something I asked it to do, but something that's very welcomed. Every time we create a project like this, it's nice to have a README talking about what this project actually does. And if we go into it, pretty basic, but I'm pretty happy that that exists rather than not existing. So done, changed files. We changed the application.properties. Here's all of the new files that we created, and you can either roll back or start a new task. So I'm just gonna say done, and we are done with that. So now if we go into our controller, we see that we have a request mapping for /API/post. This is a REST controller. It's using the post service, and it's doing this through constructor injection, which I like. And then we have our list, our get post by ID, our create, our update, and our delete. I like that it actually adds in some comments here as well as some documentation. This is really nice. So the post service, if we look at the post service, we have this REST template, and then we have this value for the base URL, and then it will go out and get all of the posts, get post by ID. I'm not going to actually run this app. I've done it before. It's worked just fine. So we'll just assume that it works. And then there is a model for a post, and this is a class. So here's what I want to talk about, kind of customizing it to our needs. So I don't mind this class. There's nothing wrong with it, but I prefer to use a record here and favor immutability whenever possible. I don't like that it uses a REST template. I would like to use a REST client here. And there are just some other things that I would like it to adhere to when writing code. So let's take a look at how we can customize Juni in this project to kind of rely on our coding preferences and standards. All right, so I'm going to delete all of this. And I'm going to create a new directory in here. This is going to be .juni. And that will be here. And then I'm going to create a new file in here called guidelines.md. And this is exactly the convention you need to follow. It's not, this is the folder and this is the name of the file that it will follow. So I'm going to put some kind of guidelines to it. And again, you can do this in whatever IDE you're using, like Cursor, Windsurf, and now Juni. But this kind of guides the LLM to your preferences. So I'm saying, hey, if you're going to use Java, use 21 unless you are told otherwise. Use this version of Spring Boot. Use Maven. When we structure the package, I noticed last time it put it into like controller, model, service. I want to avoid that package by layer. I want everything done in package by feature. So we give it some examples. We talk about data access. The HTTP client, I want you to use the REST client where possible. I want you to use records for immutable data transfer objects. Favor immutability for objects where appropriate. Here are some best practices for Spring Framework, things with testing, and then general code quality. This is a very simple guideline. You can get as detailed as you want with this, but this is really about the, you could have different guidelines for different types of projects you work on too. But this is going to give us a way to kind of guide the AI agent. So let's go back to Juni and ask it that same thing. And let's create a full CRUD REST API that retrieves data from the JSON placeholder service and let it do its thing. All right, so it is done. Here's our change files. Here's our service. Here's all the different files it created. I'm going to click done so we can just get into this. I can see it followed some of my guidelines, but not all of my guidelines, like my packaging structure. It did it in a previous attempt, so I'm not sure why it didn't do it this time, but it did follow some of my guidelines. As far as the post goes, this is a record, which is great. That's what I want. From a service perspective, it actually created a post-service interface and then an implementation. I'm not really for this, especially when I know there's only going to be one implementation. So I could probably add something to the guidelines about that. But I can see that it used a REST client, and this is good. I'd favor the REST client over the REST template. Also, it created some exceptions here. A resource not found exception, that's good. A global exception handler, oh, this is great. So I'm really happy with the way this turned out. It created a pretty good project here. Now, this is not the end-all be-all. There are some things I would change. I would change the packet structure around, go through my tests, see if those work. And again, this I think this comes back to what I said at the beginning, that when you use these AI coding tools, you are the pilot, not the passenger. Don't take this verbatim and just turn this in or submit a PR for this. This is a starting point for you. This is to help you be more productive. I can go ahead and change things around a little bit, run things, test things, and see if they are to my liking. Review the code. Make sure it's writing code that conforms to your preferences and standards. And I think this is a really good starting point. So that was a lot of fun, folks. I hope you are interested in Juni. I know I am. I like being inside of IntelliJ. So having a AI coding agent inside IntelliJ is really exciting for me. And I can't wait to see where this goes. So, hey, friends, if you learned something new today, do me a big favor. Leave me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. And as always, happy coding.